those letters will teach you something about the nature of the relationship. It'll sort of teach you a little bit about what each of your parents are like, but it can never convey to you the experience of them as parents. That's something that has to be lived. Likewise, the Bible tells us plenty of information about who God is and what God is passionate about. But until we gather and until we have the experience of meeting with God, we're never going to be able to learn what God's character is. Because it's in a group setting, when a collection of people gather for worship, that we're actually set free from the tyranny of certainty. When we're exposed to different cultures, different opinions, different worldviews, our own worldview necessarily becomes bigger. And the God who made our world becomes bigger still. When we experience God in community, we're forced to wrestle with our own biases and our own preconceptions of the way things are and the way things have always been. And certainly the way things are supposed to be. And our God becomes bigger when we worship together. Worship reveals to us that our God is not small, and if our God is not small, if the God that is with us is not small, then nothing shall be able to sustain. But worship is also where we learn who we are. In this gathering place, this collection of people from different parts of the world with different languages and different backgrounds, this is unique in today's society. This doesn't